Hey guys, welcome back to another one of my The Flash videos. So basically, this video is going to be a discussion over the one thing a whole bunch of fans have been commenting on since the airing of episode 2, the Iris Factor. And I do realize in advance and before even uploading this video or recording it that it is going to be one of those controversial videos. So just for the sake of having an adult and smart conversation in the comments down below, I'm gonna be making a simple request here. Let's just enrich the conversation by having varying opinions, rather than raging at and insulting one another. This goes to both those who would agree with me and those who wouldn't. Now a lot of fans keep discussing how The Flash currently has an Iris problem. And be it in the offense or the defense of Iris, everyone seems to be taking it so far and for the wrong reasons as well. I'm on neither side though, because I'm personally under the impression that the show is having an Iris problem, but not because of the "We are the Flash" statement. The entire thing with Iris Snowberry, "We are the Flash," seems to have inspired a lot of memes and jokes all over the place. But seriously though, is that really the problem with Iris on The Flash Season 4? Now before I venture any further though, I'd like to remind you to stay tuned to the very end of this video. I will be announcing the winner for the first giveaway round this season before this video is over and done with. So let's start off by discussing the elephant in the room first, cause I don't want that elephant parked in the comments down below. This one elephant in particular ends up taking too much parking space, overlapping with the video, you know, it becomes a real mess. So this is basically not my first rodeo with the character of Iris, and I know a lot of commenters are gonna be getting here and starting to discuss how the hatred towards Iris is fueled by racism. But unfortunately though, I couldn't agree with such a statement because it is too general. I mean, the truth is, yes, some people's hatred towards Iris is fueled by just that, and that is absolutely fucked up and disgusting at best. The rest though of the so-called hatred or discontent with the character is fueled, in my opinion, by either short-term memory loss and being unimaginative, or actually realizing the real problem we have on our hands. Now her so-called horrible and horrid statement, "No Barry, we are the Flash," that was basically her sort of repeating something that Barry stated on season 3, I just can't place the episode or the timing right now, but you do get the gist of it. That also explains why I said short-term memory loss moments ago. Now besides that as well, we all seem to be extremely good at analyzing almost everything we watch on the show. But that, however, only applies when we like what we're seeing. We'll then start searching for a zillion interpretations for every word that is being said, and at such a point we'll start making a shit ton of assumptions and building up theories, going all out basically. In this case though, it's totally different. Some of us are just like, no, we're gonna take this one literally. It just fits with our decision to hate Iris. I just mean this statement could have meant many things, like you don't have to bear this burden alone, or what affects you affect me, or we are together in it. And when you actually think about it, it does make sense this way, because these two are basically 4 episodes and a crossover away from getting married. That would also go to establish the lacking on imagination part that I mentioned early on. Now as for the tone she said it in sounding a bit or a lot bossy, I don't care about the quantity here, that's basically most women when they're frustrated. And we all just tend to live with it and kind of accept it and do what we like in the end. We just don't hit ourselves with bolts aligning though. And that comment I just made right there brings us to what I think the real reasons we have an Iris problem are, and we have a few of those. Number 1, how in the hell did she learn to program within the span of 6 months? Number 2, let's just assume she learned programming within 6 months. How then did she find the time to learn how to deal with and handle all the equipment in Star Labs? And why is she the one close to the screens almost at all times when Barry is out there, when Cisco and Caitlin and even Wally are the ones more experienced when it comes to that? Number 3, why is Cisco not leading and at the head of the stable? Least there is, why is he not the one to make the decisions of the scientific nature? Now if I remember correctly, and I think I do, before he stepped into the Speed Force, Barry spoke to Cisco like he was the one who's gonna lead going forward. So based on what qualification, other than being Barry's fiance of course, did Iris get to be the leader of this team? Number 4, why is the show turning Iris into a hypocrite just to advance the comedic plot of episode 2? Honestly, at that point it felt like character development has jumped out of the window in favor of the West Allen arc. Think about it, she ends up complaining about Barry making this one-sided decision to head into the Speed Force. Yet, she makes a one-sided decision herself to book an appointment with the couple's therapist. Now, I personally do understand how irrational emotions could be, and that she's not really blaming him for leaving or for saving the world and all that good stuff. She's just expressing her sadness and her emotions over the event in her own way, and that's okay, by the way. What is most definitely not cool there, though, is the double standards and the hypocrisy. She does the same thing she plans on complaining about. And it is really a matter of principle here. The magnitude of the one-sided decision does not really matter. So that, right there, was totally stupid. But finally, number 5. Why is Iris deciding and insisting it is a good idea for Barry to hit himself with lightning? After all, if we decide to define Iris' character in this situation, she would be the woman with limited scientific knowledge when compared to two of the other minds in the room, that being Sisko and Caitlin. But then there was as well the fact that this scene was written in this cheesy and corny manner. It just felt like total fan service for a certain brand of West Allen fans. It was like, we're sorry, we didn't do the whole lightning rod thing to bring him back from the Speed Force, but however, we have one better for you. As writers and showrunners, we decided to defy all kinds of logic, have him listen to Iris, and hit himself with a lightning bolt. So basically, the question here is what comes next. If she asks him to jump off a tower, regardless of the laws of gravity, he'll not trust science, but he would trust her? For your information, I'm a fan of both Iris and West Allen in the comics and on the show, just not the season 4 portrayal of West Allen. And I do understand that the show is trying to portray her as the strong, independent character of a woman who has more of a story than being Barry's love interest and wife-to-be. That is cool, because I personally complained about it a lot over the past few seasons. What isn't cool, though, is how it is being done on the show. What I would have actually liked to see is actual character development for her, rather than all these inconsistencies just to make the show all about her with a little bit of flash. All I wanted was for the show to make her into her comic book counterpart, a successful and smart investigative journalist. And with such a scenario, her world would basically parallel that of Barry's by day and end up colliding with his after both of them are done dealing with their jobs, both the official and the heroic ones. And I do understand that because some of you are big fans, you might feel the need to defend the character and all that good stuff. However though, and from my perspective, being a real fan is all about wanting the character to realize its true potential. So if you think of all the points that I've raised here with no bias, you might actually find yourself agreeing with me. But just in case I haven't made that clear enough, I have no issue with the acting for the role or with the actress herself. She's pretty good, the problem for me is more the writing than the actress. But that's all I've got on this topic though. But congratulations to Gun Barrel Kalashnikov for winning the $25 Amazon gift card. Please make sure you send me a private message here on YouTube with your email so I could gift you the card. I'll also be starting another giveaway on my DCTV videos later on this week, so stay tuned for that. I'm just trying to figure out what it should be for. Want to make it something more personal to these shows, possibly the DVD or Blu-ray box set for one of them. Now, as I did state when all these new seasons started, I'm not necessarily gonna be reviewing episodes of all 4 Arrowverse shows and Gotham on a weekly basis, especially when episodes feel more like fillers. And even though this week's episode of Supergirl was pretty decent, pretty likable, with the whole Martian theme, John's father, and the return of Megan to the fold of the show, it was still a filler. But for one thing, I definitely disliked the fact that it interrupted this development of Samantha's character, who's destined to become Rain. I would have liked to have watched some of that on the episode. But setting that aside, I did like the episode. All the guest stars did a pretty good job, including Carlos Bernard, who happens to have always been one of my favorite actors on 24 in his role as Tony Almeida. Worth mentioning here as well is the episode had a couple of fun touches to its name. Funny is more like it, actually. Those included the Phil Coulson Transformers hybrid car that is the Martian ship. They also included John's comment about being careful with the leather and Kara's reaction to it. And finally, there was the Kara Britney Spears moment, which was a laughing out loud moment for me. So let me know in the comments if you believe we have a rising Iris problem on The Flash Season 4, and if you share my opinion on the reasons or have ones of your own. Let me know as well if you liked the third episode of Supergirl and if you thought it was quite the entertaining installment the way I did. But finally, if you did like the content of this video, make sure you drop it a much appreciated like. And if that were to be the case, remember as well to subscribe and enable notifications for my future videos. And until I see you next time, thank you all for watching and have a good one.